Hello everyone and welcome to the stream. We are returning to Factorio Production Scrap today. And what I have on the plan is I need to set up a little bit of concrete to be made. And then I need to work on yellow science, utility science. Last time we worked on purple science, which is production science. That's set up over here. And since the last episode, I set up the robot network, so we now have logistics and construction bots throughout the... Click the right icon here. Throughout much of the base, not the whole thing. I just kind of got started on it. And then I also started looking at... Let's see, I upgraded all of the smelting to steel furnaces and red belts. I doubled the stone bricks because we're going to need them very soon for the concrete. And then I also noticed, you don't see it, so it's not so bad right now because this has been running without any research running, so the base has been pretty idle. But when this is running fairly well, the base is running fairly well, you end up with some decent backup here. So I may end up having to change the way that these push the items out into the smelter areas especially, and then to a lesser extent perhaps these breaking down areas. So I started looking at a possible sort of filter that would handle all four belts simultaneously, and this will fit in the space that I've given myself here, and it's fairly short for having to touch all four belts, and it goes into two splitters which can then connect to this splitter here. So that kind of gives us a nice sort of balance, but I don't know if we'll need it yet or not. I'm going to run this a little bit longer and see. The other thing I noticed is there's gray science on this scrap belt, and that is because one of their, I guess I could show you the recipe. One of these produces gray science as part of its output. So we're going to deal with that eventually. We also have to deal with explosives on that belt eventually. I'm not sure what to do with the explosives yet. The gray science is easy. It just needs to get sent back up to the science area, to the labs. So I think we're going to do some concrete first. We need the concrete so that we can start making some nuclear stuff. And I want to just see how much the concrete kind of mess is going to make. It looks like it just produces stone. But I wanted to make it down here because I want to just shunt the stone right back into this stone smelting. In between, while finishing up the end of last stream, and in between the streams, I finished all of the... everything that doesn't require purple science. So I'm just going to queue up a bunch of sort of early and sort of necessary purple science items right now, including the nuclear stuff. We won't need that anytime soon, but I'll start it up anyway. Trains, no. Coal liquefaction, probably not. We can do that one. So I'm just going to get those queued up because that'll also help us with the potential issue with the science, or the scrap building up. I think I'm going to use this nice open area here for concrete making. And concrete doesn't require a whole lot of effort. Let's do three. It's basically iron ore, stone bricks, and water. And I think I'll just do an output belt here in the middle. I've all but switched over to red belts now. All my items that I have left over are all red belts. And I'm going to put these in the middle. And then we'll do another pair here. Then I can deal with the pipes this way. Let's see, we'll put the pipes on the outside, I think. Just cross them over and run them out. I think we're only going to need these four. We don't really need a whole lot. And we're just going to need one iron ore every 10 seconds each. So I'm just going to steal it off of this line going to the circuits. I'm not that worried about it. And we'll just add more circuit iron when we need it. Not a huge deal. Oh, I guess we need a belt here. And a belt here. Oops, wrong place. we'll need this. There's my straight line drawing skills. Wonder if I should move these up just to kind of keep everything in there together. Need inserters here and here. Oh, we also need stone. That was a little bit crazy of me. I think the best way to handle that is to take these back down or back out. Let's take these out. I think the best way to handle this is just to take half belts of each. And then we'll just split off of this and run it into there. Need a splitter. Let's see, this belt's gonna go right here. So we need a splitter right here. Underground that. Go underground with this. Backed up one more. Look at that, bot delivery. And we'll just take this guy down like that. And that'll do good enough for what we need here. I'm not too worried about it. There's some junk. Then I just want to take these over here and we'll build a water well. Stone water well. What do we need? Stone that I just got rid of. Excellent. One of those. These take a little bit to build. I'm close enough here to the water. I probably could have just ran a pipe, but I don't think I need it. And we need inserters here and here, out there, 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 there. I'm actually going to put this on a belt and run it down just so that my logistics box bots are so early in the game right now that I think I'm going to just run it on a belt and let them pick it up a little bit closer. So we have, what do we have open for belts? Plastic. I mean, one option is to bring it down here where the green circuits are and unload it right there. Since these belts aren't going to be used for anything anyway. We're actually a bit lower than that because I want to put a few more machines here. The other alternative is to use... Yeah, let's do this. Let's use one of these other belts on the scrap bus. Oh, I forgot. I forgot to filter and feed the stone back. Take a few more machines. That'll be more than enough, I think. Filter your splitter in here. Left priority for the stone. Put these guys up. We'll just bring this right back this way. Like that. Oops. That'll be fine. They're not going to produce that much scrap stone. Either one. It shouldn't be that big of a deal. Okay, we have a little bit of extra belts here. Let's bring this right down. This looks goofy here, but that's okay. I should really kind of maximize these just to be more efficient about it. Too far. Of course it is. Let's use the cheaper ones here then. There. Exactly aligned to the belt. Okay. I knew I had some copper in my bags. little bit of stone, but that's okay. Or I could just be lazy with the stone and dump it on that scrap bus. And let the scrap bus handle it. Alright, so, and the reason I'm talking about putting it on the... letting the bots handle it is because there's actually a collection, or a requester chest in here, wherever it is, in here, which I can't actually use yet because I don't have those researched. We'll do those in a little bit when we research the science. But we can at least get it down here. Could potentially run it up to the mall. So it gets it even a little bit closer. It's not a bad idea. I can just run it right up, put it right here in the middle someplace. Go ahead and turn it right now and run it up that way then. Let's go a couple spaces away here. Then I'll just load it into a couple of provider chests. I think I have some in my bag. Yes, I do. It's a good place for it. Didn't hook it up yet. Alright, so we'll just let that... Oh, I need to fill those chests up, though. Let's filter. Let's limit those to... stack each should be plenty. So I'm not going to actually be able to use it just yet, though, because I don't have requester chests. But I guess I could kind of cheat it a little. And make it a storage chest. Filtered storage chest. Then force the bots. I need to put a roboport up here then. But force the bots to think that it's... Let's see this. Okay, good. Nobody's headed here. We can force the bots to think that there's scrap or concrete in the network to try and deal with it. So I didn't need the big pole. Oh, thank you. All right, so you should bring up. You're bringing that up here. And I can do that just by picking up some, like I have, and telling the bots to come and collect it for me. Then that way it'll put it in the network. And that'll at least get some going with the nuclear stuff. It's not a lot, but it'll be enough. Make a couple things. I don't actually know if the nuclear produces any off products. It actually doesn't look like it. So that may just be something that I set up either very quickly or even off camera, because they didn't actually make it produce any scrap, which is kind of odd. But we saw the oddness with the oil processing, so might as well have a little bit more oddness. All right, I'm going to ride this belt while we look at yellow science. So for yellow science, don't have these set up and going yet. I'll have to go back to the mall in order to do that. So we'll just do 1.5 per second, which is, I believe, what we did for the rest of them. Yes. And this produces some scrap, which doesn't surprise me. Let's see. I'll start with low density structures. Even though there's a lot of them, they're also the simplest. They just require 3 basic ingredients without any sort of complex thinking. So we're going to need a red belt of copper. 40 machines. A red belt of copper. And then a little bit of plastic and steel. I think what I'll do for these... Well, first we need... First... We need 14 machines making yellow science. So I'm going to line those up. I believe purple was 14 machines as well. Yes. I'm just going to line those up right across from the purple machines. Yellow. Because there will be an input belt here of something, and an input belt here of something. Because I could have extended the belts all the way. Inputs. Outputs. So that is 2, 6, 8, 10, 12, and 14. And we don't have any bots that far up. See where I have a RoboPort. I can put these guys a little bit to work a little bit here. That should at least cover a good chunk of the what I have coming up with the network. So for the... Let me request some yellow belts, because I'm still going to use them for this construction, and that way I can... I mean, I can do the ghost image placement easily enough, but if I can get away with it, I might as well. Alright, so full belt is going to be these, and then a half belt of each of these coming into science. So I think what I'll do is I will have a yellow belt of copper, making low density structures, and then I will have a half belt of steel and plastic. I'll have an output belt, and then another yellow belt of copper. A lot of machines too. Let's bring me like 100 of those. Am I still in the zone here? Yes, for now. Not for long, but for now. Alright, I would really like to be able to set that recipe. I guess I could do it this way. Okay, I can't set the recipe. I probably just messed up my bots, but that's okay. Oh, inserters. And then inserting from here. Let's see, outputting. Outputting here. Inserting there, outputting there. Yep. So that takes care of the recipe we need for low density structures, which is why, and I just walked out of the zone and made my bots mad. Need a lot of these, so I'm doing a double row. 2, 4, 8, 12, 16, 20. That's half. And then half again. Run this way so that I stay within the RoboPort range. I could stand right here and not make my bots mad. That is 40 of those. All right. This is why I wanted the concrete up near them all, because I knew they would not be happy about it. Nearly researched everything we had set up already. That's already in the queue. We can do the labs. We'll do modules 3. We're going to run out of purple science stuff here pretty soon. We'll put the next inserter capacity on there too. But that's okay, because it won't take us very long to make this yellow science, and we'll have those ready to go. Interested to see, while the bots are coming around, to see what we have for garbage here. So this is what I saw earlier. As you can see, there are a bunch of iron plates, scrap plates, that are getting past here because this belt is just too full to shove this stuff in well. So I think doing something like this is going to be much more beneficial for the base. And look, that belt's way backed up. Yeah, we're going to have to deal with that. Probably sooner rather than later. Let's just run down there. We'll let the bots keep building the that array of low-density structures. And we'll just run down to the scrap dispensary there and deal with this mess. I think I can probably pull this out now. We don't really need it anymore. Stuff. That one too. Following here. Okay. So I started to say, I don't remember if I finished saying, I upgraded all the smelting to red belts and stone furnaces, and I also did the same for the green circuits, but I did not expand green circuits yet, and it looks like I'm going to need to, because they are not producing very many, and we're just consuming them all. So let's try this out with the copper and the iron. I'm a little less concerned about it with the stuff over here, but more of the copper and the iron. So let's cut this off, maybe right about there. Let it all flow, so I don't have to pick up as much trash. Alright, I don't know what that's from. Oh, it's probably from those inserters from before that come out too. So, I played with this just for a few minutes, and I hope it will work. But basically, it just splits off of each... I didn't check that. Good thing that fits. It basically just allows each belt to pull from the... or to pull the same scrap from each belt. And I need to change these filters. And then insert them into the... into the smelter, and then we don't have to worry about it at shoving everything to one belt and then losing or letting things pass repeatedly. Let's see how this works. Now, of course, this could still get backed up because this is only a yellow belt's worth of capacity here, but it is starting to get backed up a little bit. But that's still way more possibility here than we had, and I can always upgrade these to steel furnaces and red belts, and then we'll be able to process twice as much, because four yellow belts can go into, you know, I mean, it'll go twice as fast here. So that might be the next thing to do, and I have an upgrade plan already set for that, because that's what I was using for the other smelting upgrades. So I think that's working better, but I do think we're going to need to do this upgrade. Let's go ahead and do it. I don't bother wasting... We're probably going to need to upgrade that output belt too. I don't bother wasting the upgrade stuff on the coal belt, because, well, it's a waste. You don't really need it, because the coal isn't used near as much as everything else is. Let's do that one, but not the other two, I don't think. Ready. I see the bots are down here doing some work, but I'm going to speed them along. So I'm probably going to upgrade this output belt too. Just take it all the way up to the bus. As red. Okay, I think I got it all. I see the base bots are still working away. I don't have any steel furnaces left. Like they got in my inventory, but it looks like they got all of it. Let's get rid of that scrap. Let's have an auto trash turned on. I do, for 200. That's fine. As long as they keep a couple hundred belts, there should be plenty. So this is already picked up and has already flushed out these. I wonder if I should upgrade these. I think they're fine. Because it can't handle that much capacity anyway. Yeah, that looks so... That made such a difference. Just those two. And I think... I mean, we'll have to see how this works out. Actually, let's do a shifter down here right after this last split off, or the last underground from the split off, just to make sure that everything is shifted after this. We're gonna have to get these explosives and stuff off of here, but that way everything is shifted over, and as much as possible the generic scrap can get pulled into here and then shifted again. I did put some balancers in here, some lane balancers, just to make sure the belts were a little more evenly distributed. But then all of the stuff that these need to process is in this first belt. And so they can pull it off and put it into their processing. We may need to double the circuit one. Actually, let's go ahead and double it. Let's just do it. I'm going to just copy this middle section here, and not the middle section, but the first section here. Copy it an extra belt. Hopefully that'll help those speed along. What do we have going on here? Oh, I need to extend this too. That would help. That would help. Grab this much, I think. Yep, that'll do. Don't really need these ones here. Or these ones. Wow, that's a lot of circuit scrap. And we're still not moving. Why are we not moving? We are low on water. We have used all the water. Let's rehook the water up really quick. Some pressure in here. I don't want to let it go full. Unless I put tanks. I could always put tanks in here too. And I perhaps should. We're low on sulfuric acid too, so I should connect that one up real briefly. That looks good. We're about two-thirds full. These up. Let that also get about two-thirds full. Excuse me. Yeah, it's close enough. Sorry to mute myself, I started coughing even more. This is, of course, uneven. We must be pulling unevenly when we're making the rails. Oh yeah, because we're only doing a half a belt here. Okay, well we need to fix that quickly here. Splitter, we'll just do a yellow splitter. That's not enough space. Alright, let's do... You want some stone. And then I'll get rid of this scrap that I'm carrying. That looks so much better. So it's still taking a little bit of time to get it all in here, but it's still handling it a lot better than it was. And it's just because so much of the smelting scrap is coming in here. I did flip these priorities. I'm wondering now if I don't want to do that, if I want to flip them back. Let's see how that goes. I flipped them thinking that would fix the problem before. It didn't work. So that's when I started working on the development of the other piece. At least this will flush out these belts and get it backed up in here. I'm still not sure which one of those is better, but either one will be fine. Okay, let's get back up here to I need to add some shifters here. That's bad. Not that it's going to matter a whole lot because we're not even producing that whole belt worth, but at least we'll get some of this belt back up here. Might as well use it for making it. So hopefully these are done. I'm assuming they are. One lone tree in the middle of my factory here. So the next piece is the complicated one, which is flying robot frames. Machines. 13.33, of course. Why not? So that's 14, basically. That means we need 6.7 of these, so 7 of those. Which is also means we need 7 of these. And then some gears. And some pipes. Right. So less than one of each of those. That's good. Why is it such an odd number? Is it because of the 0.5? Probably. Okay. So, we need 14 of these. Alright, so, actually, before I do that, let's look at how these are going to connect in. This belt needs to go here. And then the other belt will come across around here. I have to do a little bit of spaghetti here. Just to move out of the way of my balancer. Or we could move this... Or my filter, or you can move this down just a little bit so you don't have to squiggle. That's probably a better option. I'd like to catch it when there's nothing in there, but there's never going to be nothing in there, I suppose. Let's just do it. Oops. Gone. Oh no. That would have been really bad. Really bad. Left. Science. Hope none of it made it out the scrap belt. Suppose if it did, we'll find it down in the scrap area someplace. Oh, so we need to deal with scrap for these too. Ha! Huh. Oh, yeah, right here. We'll just deal with it right here. Perfect place. Those, we'll just go with that. So these produce just copper scrap. Oh, that's convenient. So we'll go right, copper scrap. And we'll go, we don't need red, this. This will be the underground for that. That'll work. There and there. Just gonna line this guy up here. Oop, we don't need those belts. I don't know why I couldn't move my hand like that, but that's okay. So, for the frames, we're going to need 4 inputs and 1 output. Let's think about how this is going to work. The electric engines need... open up this instead. The electric engines need green circuits. The flying robot frames need green circuits, so that should be somehow shared between the two of them. Flying robot frames need steel, batteries. These need steel. That should be a shared belt between the two of them. So perhaps the way to do it would be to put the electric engines themselves on the same belt as the batteries. and then have the green circuits and the steel be on a belt that is shared between both the assemblies. Let's get rid of some of these trees. Trees always in the way. I really didn't want to pick them up, but I guess that's alright. The base bots do it, because then they'll just take it to the trash box, of which I probably need to add one, to be fair to them. They're going to be complaining pretty soon. I thought I put a box of those out. Alright, we'll have to look at that at some point. And I'm too close, because of course. So, if we have 13 of these, or 14 of these, I think, right? 14, yes. Look at the mass exodus. These can come down this way. They can go that way. The ran out of juice, huh? The batteries can come in from the bus this way. And mix with the frame. No, the batteries. I'm sorry. That's going to be the blue circuits coming in there. From over here someplace. This will be... The batteries will come in this way. The engines need to come across somehow. So to make sure the batteries are on the same side of the belt here. Or give myself some more space, which I might do. And then this will be steel and circuits coming in here. Engines will go that way. Okay. So this will be a whole column with just 14 of these. So then we need one of these, and 7 of each of these. I think the best place to put the engines will be right here. I think right here. We'll put the gears and the pipes down below here. Because we have a lot of space here, it's just a... gets it to be a little bit messy otherwise. Or maybe I'll move these up. We'll see. It's probably the better option. So, if that's steel and circuits coming in here, that's going to have to continue on past these to where the electric engines go. On this side will be the pieces from the iron. And then we can have the engines going on an outer belt out here. And then once we get to the top of the engine makers, we'll have the lubricant or the electric engines here. They need lubricant, they need the green circuits, and they need the engines. So we'll just flip this in, and then we can output the electric engines onto an outer belt here, and then come across here and drop onto this belt. I think that'll work. All right, let's make this. There. There. We didn't deal with any scrap yet. Need to do that. Yeah, so I need to give myself a little bit more space between these assemblies to deal with the scrap. So these are going to produce logistics scrap. We'll need a space here to put a splitter in and drop it under. So let's move this whole thing over one. And then we'll move this whole thing over one. I guess I could have done that a little smarter. Because I think I want to do this way. Just to make sure that nothing is side-loaded crazily. Yeah, could have done that way smarter. Because this needs to go like this now. No, we need to turn it sooner. Put a splitter in here, not one of those. That's a waste. write output for the frames. Then we'll go under, don't need that. I need to request some more other belt pieces here, just a stack. Don't need much, and I'm locked into that anyway. Okay. This is going to be the blue circuits, right? Yes. Which will come from over here someplace. Okay, so you can go that way. Go that way. Oh, and then you need to output this way. Yeah, I think I can just shift these guys up some. Much up. That. Of course I was one off. Then here will be 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Figure that part out. Here will actually be the outputs for these pieces, the gears and the pipes. Not really bothered by which side they go on because we aren't going to need a whole belt of them anyway. I need some place to put the iron. I know what I can do with the iron. I've done this once before. I can shift these guys over one and bring the iron in right here. Iron gears need two of them. Did I do two when I did bots before? I must have. Pipes should only need one. You deal with their scrap, which I will deal with right here. Left goes the iron scrap. Nope. Iron scrap. So this will be engines. Let's continue on with the engines. Oh, I should have left that belt. For the copy feature, we need 7 of these. 6. And then that's going to be my first electric engine. That must be outside of the range of the base belts. Okay. That power pole over. I'm not sure which direction yet. I haven't figured that part out yet. You don't need to continue this way. Let's do that. And then we can shift this belt in that contains the engines. I'm going to copy this, not that one, this one again. Up here, change the recipe. Trick, because I could have borrowed the recipe from before. Okay, so that's 3. So these are going to pick up green circuits from here. They'll pick up their engines from here, and they'll output their electric engines here, which actually is going to be a downward-headed belt. But first, I need to split off of here the engine scrap. Go left. Engine scrap. Right, that's all those output. Yes. These have engine scrap and circuit scrap. I need to deal with that separately. Yep, this needs to be a downward direction belt. I would like to... No, I can't do that. I'd like to do it, but I can't do it. I think we'll just do it this way. Yeah, and then what I can do here is split off to the right the electric engines. Then we can do a splitter here to merge these in. Scrap can continue. Electric engines can continue on down to the bottom. I'll just side load that on, that'll be fine. Scrap. Alright, so we need to bring these down a bit. Yeah, that's fine. We're done with our research. All right, let's just do, what do we have, three left? Let's just do them. And then these will be the blue circuits coming in here. Go. No, you don't need that advanced of an inserter. Or underground, I mean. That. Spaghetti mess, but it'll be fine. Okay, so we're dealing with this scrap, and this scrap. Need to get the lubricant in here. I think this is probably the best place to run it. Is right here. We move these inserters out one block. Oh, I need a copy. Well, we'll wait. Now we can copy this. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I know trees in the way. There's some more trees. More trees go by way. Out of belts again. I think, yes, this is just barely in the bot zone. So the bots can deal with it. We don't need that pipe. Don't need these belts or this belt or that belt. That's a nice knot of spaghetti there. I like it. Oops. So, there. Well, there. Then I think I will do a little bit of this here. Just so I don't have to mess up those pipes at all. Of course. Of course you do. Go there, and I can bring it all the way down here. This is, once again, the science bus, even though we really don't need it anymore here. So I'm not going to put it in here. Take these guys out. Actually, we might need it here. Now that I think about it, we might actually need it. Because I may put more labs down on this end. I don't know yet. If I need them at some point later in the game, this is where they'll go. It's better to have them than not have them. Thank you, bots. Let's copy. Copy. Outbound, outbound, inbounds. Looks like spaghetti, but I think it's good. Okay, so the next thing we need is the blue circuits. And I'm going to do a small dedicated blue circuit array inside the yellow science, just because that way it's a dedicated array. I'm going to plan for I'm going to do one salad or one yellow belt full of greens, and then a yellow belt half green, half red, and then an output belt. Going to do, let's see, I know we have some space issues here. This will be our output belt here. Input comes in here. That machine is purposely misaligned. Circuits. Let's see, we'll put the power pole on that side. The pipes can come out this side. Because we're also going to have a belt here. And we need this. There's going to be inserters and outserters. So, it doesn't really matter which one, which belt I use for which component, because they're both blue inserters, but one will be green and the other will be green and red combined. We need 14 of these. Yeah. 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. I'll go ahead and pick these up. I just don't want to do it. See that I have some in my factory, and I don't like trees in my factory. There. There. Pipe. There. I don't know where I left my pipes. They're way back there someplace. So, now we need to put this all back together again. Hope that it's correct. This is copper. It's an easy one. We're going to very, very quickly here run out of copper on the bus. But that's okay. Scrap coming out. This is plasti-steel coming in. Yes. Thank you, bots. Keeping me well supplied. Probably don't really care which side these are on. I probably should, but I probably don't. We don't need that one. Not yet, anyway. Okay. Just to add to the sort of confusion that they are almost the same color, need to extend our bus too. This is the scrap belt. Base bots take care of that. Oh, or I can help. This is the other copper belt here. That should take care of frames. There are low density structures on that belt, so that's good. And we are filtering out the copper scrap, so that's good too. All right. And once the base bots get cracked in there, better off. This is another scrap belt. Of course we are. This input belt here is the batteries. Oh, I never extended this. That would have been bad. That would have been quite bad. Well, it wouldn't have been bad, but I think there's 14 of these. That one. Sorry. Yep, 14. Copy that. Or 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Base bots have enough? Yes, they do have enough coverage. So this is batteries coming in. Yeah, batteries mixing with the engines. Are exhausted. On this side, it is steel and green circuits. And I did that one backwards. There we go. Oops. I've already upgraded this. They need to be red now. There. For that matter, that can go there. Okay, steel and green circuits. Next up, iron. Kind of unfortunate, but we'll spaghetti this one in so that it looks good. Because we're going to have to split it off right here. Do it like that. That's okay. This is our mega scrap belt from all the engine making stuff. The base bots are probably pretty mad at me now because I keep walking in and out of the logistics zone, so they can't resupply me. They probably get 3/4 of the way here, and then I walk away. And then they can't resupply me at all. Circuits of steel. Oh, we need to hook the lubricant up. Let's go down and get the stay in the logistics zone for a while. I'll head down and grab the pipes where we left off with them. Looks like they're right there. Yeah, I've got some upgrading to do on the green circuits. Oh boy. Oh boy. Alright, we'll put one right here. And hopefully it'll reach this far. Yep, right there. To go, yep. And of course I put the lube right where I have a road port, so I'm gonna have to fix that. Wonder if I should just cross it over and put it, bring it down this side. That would be a little bit better. Try that out. Underground, I don't need that. Underground that. Come over there. Come down this side instead. Back that one up. This is still a bit, well, we can do it this way. I finally do have some stuff. Excellent. Let's see, pipe. Do it that way. Alrighty, so we have, do we have everything we need now for the, I don't want to jump out of my zone here, so I'm being careful. So we are making this stuff. These machines are cooking. These machines are slowly getting supplies. Hopefully it's just the engines they're waiting on. They just haven't made enough yet. Just like it. Got one more we can do here. Here. That might be it. How bad is our recycling looking? Looks like we need to double the belt recycling. Why are they stuck? Too much garbage water. Not enough scrap water recycling. Okay. So we have some more expansion to do down there too. But those are a couple of good things that'll be good for next stream, because once I finish hooking up these... Yep, here comes the electric engines. Oh, they're already started. Never mind. Once I finish hooking up these blue circuits, I think that'll be it for today's stream. And then next time we'll plan on expanding out our scrap processing and a couple other things. Alright, so that's working. We know that's working. So we hope it's working properly. Great lines, Wally. This was either green circuits or green circuits and red circuits. I think I'll do the full belt first. Doesn't really matter. But I think I'll do it that way. There, you go there. Undergrounds, go lower. Let's see, this goes here. Here. That goes there. Oh, we are at least getting some green circuits this far down the bus. That's pretty good. See, we have some imbalance in the... And I forgot to do this the whole way again. Copy, paste. Paste. That's the last one of those. Need it here. And down here. Oh, we missed a bunch of iron ones. Excellent. Well, hopefully that... Oh, we need to hook up the sulfuric acid. Let's just do these last two here. And we'll run back down and hook that sulfuric acid up. And that should be... Ooh, scrap on the blue chips. Thank you. And welcome. Hi, hello, and welcome. They produce circuit scrap. Good catch. We can handle that one very easily right in here. Left, blue circuits. You know what? We're gonna handle this even better. I'm merging it in with this one. Do that. Suppose I could have done it a little better than that even. Really? Inventory full? Alright, what are we carrying so much of that I don't want? this. Holy cow, lots of wood. All right, where are you at? Output left. Blues. There we go. Good catch, thank you very much. That would have been very messy later. You can come in here. Go in there. Go to town, blue circuits. Hey, look, I got batteries and plastic bars in my inventory too. These are one of those machines so they can go out. I just want to make sure everything is working. Comes the blue circuits. We have had some robot frames, so there should be some on the belt. They're backed up for a while. Excellent. It's all gone now. Poof. Did I miss it? No, still the first one's coming. Oh yeah, these take forever. 21 seconds. But they produce 3, so what are you gonna do? I mean, these are the same, so. There they go. I see them. All right, our first yellow science. Excellent. So next time we will deal with expanding the green circuits, dealing with the scrap a little bit more thoroughly, more good or better, and perhaps if we get all that done and it's all working, we could start working on some rocket stuff. But I have a horrible supply of green circuits here that need to get resolved. I may set up a bunch of smelting between now and the next episode, just so that we have ample smelting for the green circuits and for probably the copper. Also here on the bus, and I may do another smelting column of iron as well. So maybe I'll go a third belt of iron, a second belt of copper, and then here I'll do maybe two more coppers and another iron. That should work. And then we can expand the green circuits on camera and deal with some of this mess over here. Holy cow, that is a mess. Epic proportions. And they can't run because we are full of this. Wow. Okay. Excellent. Alrighty. So that's it for tonight. Thanks for coming. And I'll see you again on Tuesday at the same time. Have a good night. Bye, everyone.